Hi everybody, we're today in the Trossachs and today we're doing something different. We're doing a wild camp at Loch Drangey, which we can see here in front of us, because the weather is just not good enough for the highlands. It's not worth it, and we thought that we will do just somewhere here a nice wild camp. With us is Robert today. As you can see, we have plenty with us. We have chairs, we have wood, we have just everything for a glamorous camping experience. And now we are just looking for a camp spot. So, and this looks already like the perfect spot. So putting the tarp up, I have today a tarp with me. I will set it up like a tarp tent, and we can work with this. Let's get started. And right now I'm not particularly sure where I want to have the entrance, but the wind would usually come from the water, I would assume, so I do the entrance in your direction. And you can see, you know, it's like straight out, and I put here a ground nail in here, and then on the other sides as well. The second one, just have a look that it's more or less tight here between the. And then here as well, that we have a tight line. So, and the next step is that I use this corner and put it in here roughly, and this one to here. And then we put the trekking pole in the middle and can lift it up. And this basically determines how wide your entrance is. And right now, you can see, as soon as I have the pack in, that our door will be like this wide from here. And now we'll use a trekking pole, put it in the middle up, and it looks already really squinty. So we have now the trekking pole out, and what I also like to do, I have a pair of spare socks. I put this one like a cover on top of my trekking pole, that I'm not damaging in any kind the tarp. So let's have a look. So looks already not too bad. Now we tie like on the splits here. This one will come to the front out, and this one we tie just to the rear. So, and this is how it looks like from inside, how I set it up. I have the ground sheet from the Lanshan, then the satellite, and my sleeping bag. Here I have like food and crucial stuff. The rucksack I have here, which in the night I will push to the front, that I get not the draft. And now let us go out and look at Robert's tent, how it looks like. So, and Robert's using the Vango Mirage 200 Pro again. Yeah, nicely in between of two locks.
What I said, brilliant.
Still be impressed with the tent after the wind test, which I completely understand. Yeah, and he used the trekking poles like to hold the doors open. Probably a nice thing as long as the rain comes from the top. Here we have our fire pit, our camping chairs, and this is then the view which we're having from our campsite, which is pretty good. And we are trying now to put a tarp up. Robert brought the orange one, that we look that we get some more construction from here and from this tree, high lines, and then it goes over this where we would sit. is obviously not the best conditions.
Yeah.
I have some perch in here and some kingspan or fatwood. In German it's a kingspan. It doesn't get much better than a fire. Yeah, it's always immediately comfortable. And later on, when it burns down, I will put my torty in. And afterwards, we will probably put the asparagus and the steak on, and Robert will have some sausages and some other stuff, but you will see.
Look at this. Cook the steak in that as well, why?
I would wait if we have a flat.
So it's all melted and.
Yeah, just down that we can put the pans on to fry our stuff.
Cool. Well, mate.
What are you having?
Coffee to start with, and I'll put some beans in it, and then I'll put some Scotch eggs in it.
So, you know, potato. So I put the backpack in front of the door. It doesn't draft too much in with the cold air. And hey, I wish you a good night and see you tomorrow morning. Good night.
Just beautiful. So we will put now our stuff together slowly, and then we head home. It's like from here just 35 minutes for us. And I hope you enjoyed our tour, even if it was not in the mountains, but it makes really no sense when it was, yeah, when it's raining and cloudy and everything. So other things to explore as well in beautiful Scotland, not just the hills. And hey, see you next time. Bye.